So good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Namaste. I am Daksh. I am the founder of Love World. And I think we have met before on some of the other call. So I hope you'll enjoy today's 30 or 40 minutes as well. So the topic for today, or the topic that, you know, we actually changed in the last three or four talks, is really interesting. Because we're all right now looking at restarting the school, or actually going back to school, or in some time being prepared to initiate the school operations. So the biggest challenge, or the biggest, you know, the pivot that actually runs the whole system, is a teacher. And it, as of now, it's getting very difficult to actually visualize the role of the teacher in the new or the post-lockdown school. So the topic for today is basically to build an understanding and share your ideas on what do you think would a future teacher look like, or how would the future of your current teacher look like? So either you talk about the future teacher or the future of your current teacher. Let's see what you think on those lines. But to further expound the topic and give it a more detailed view on what kind of questions or what kind of answers that we are looking from you, or the kind of perspective that we want from you, today we have with us Charu, the co-founder of Third Flix, and Practically. They're basically an education technology content creator platform. So more details Charu will share, but Charu will actually bring out the exact questions whose answers we are looking from all of you today. So she'll actually detail and structure the topic for you, for it, so that it gets easier for you to respond. So Charu, over to you for the next 3 minutes. You can unmute yourself and, you know, give them a brief about the topic.
Sure. Thank you so much. Thanks, Daksh. I'm so happy to meet all of you. A very good evening. And I'm Charu Noiri. I'm the co-founder for Practically. It's a new product that we have recently launched. It's part of the Third Flix Visual Effects Private Limited umbrella. So this is our second product. The first one was in core assessments. And this one is more around content leading, next gen content product. So just introducing today's topic, I'll just bring out my presentation. So while that is happening, so I've been interacting with a lot of teachers, school principals, administrators as part of our, you know, my job. And I think one of the very, very interesting things I've noticed is that I think K-12 specifically, not higher ed, but K-12 was one industry which had taken... was in a very slow moving technology adoption segment for some reason, right? Where technology has become a core subject. In fact, computer science is one of the core subjects. We start teaching students computers. Every school has a computer lab. But I think K-12 from a school perspective was not very, fully adopted, so to speak. Not every teacher is tech savvy, used to be tech savvy. So what COVID now has proved is that there is potential for everyone to learn overnight, right? So every teacher in India, every teacher in Middle East I speak to in Southeast Asia has jumped on technology. And I think this is going to be here for the good. And that's what I am seeing. And so business from an, coming from an education technology space, I think this is good news for all of us in that, we are seeing that momentum now growing into adoption of technology tools, products, how the role itself of a teacher evolves around the evolution in the peripheral area is something we are, going to talk about today. So, the topic, as Daksh was saying, was future teacher or teacher's future. And, we at the company's core believe learning is an experience and everything else is information. And so said Einstein. That, learning is something that, there is no pass and fail in learning, right? Whereas, when you start testing students, everything else is something that you can test. But learning, so to speak, has to be an experience. It's all around us. We learn from everything around us. So that's what, we can continue to believe. This next point I wanted to cover is, how is this new role of teachers emerging, right? Post-COVID, I mean, you guys would have seen in your schools, your peer group as well, where there is a sentiment shift this is like a step function in the life of your particular organizations as well. You wouldn't have seen things changing overnight so quickly. Now teacher's role has become not just, I would say, delivering content in the classroom, right? Teacher's role has become more around like a, okay, I am able to share the screen now. So everybody can see my screen?
Yeah.
Okay, good. So what I was just saying, so now teacher's role itself has been in flux, right? Earlier, it's no longer just delivering content or delivering, any kind of just knowledge delivery is not something, we are seeing that teachers will be doing for the, a post-lockdown when the schools open. I think they will be more looked at like a coach, like a guide, like a mentor, more like a facilitator. I'm hearing from the industry, right? Some people have come out and said entertainer, also an innovator, because we've seen teachers really innovate in the last 2 months. I mean, it's been really, really fascinating to see some of the teachers. And I think Daksh has been also posting a lot on social media about what innovations teachers are doing within their schools, within their classrooms, how to keep learning and teaching, going. They've been acting like enabler, like a catalyst also, right? So this is now the emerging role of a teacher, so to speak, going forward. And teachers will be more around, holistic learning, and they themselves have to be on their A game to be more, to actually not just survive, so to speak, but also to continue, to be comfortable in this space, right? So this is something we are seeing. But how many teachers will really be comfortable in this space is yet to, we have to see schools open up, whether in a virtual space or a physical space. How many teachers will continue to do things that they're doing right now and continue to make, use of technology over time is yet to be seen. So that's something interesting to think about. From an industry perspective, again, we've been hearing a lot of these comments, what about lifelong learning for teachers? We keep thinking about, teachers create lifelong students, right? They inculcate this value that you should continue to learn lifelong. But do we spend enough time with our teachers? Do we give them enough space to learn themselves, right? To evolve with new technology, with new features, new methods of delivering content, new methods of teaching, what is going on in the West, what is going on, in other parts of the world. So do we give them that enough space? Like continued medical education is a terminology you all have seen for doctors, right? Is there something like that for teachers as well? Some of the other topics, that debates that I've heard is, how do we build teacher capacity? Like in COVID now, you would have seen, everyone talks about bed capacity, doctor capacity, especially in the US and here, a lot of debate going on. How do we build that capacity? How do we make sure that we are prepared for that boom of cases? But have you ever thought about building teacher capacity? The student is changing, right? The ratio of teacher to student earlier when I was studying was like 1:60, 1:80 also, right? Now it's come down to 1:30, 35, 40. Maybe in the future we are, faced with a lot more students because, a lot of these developing countries like India are going to strive with more than 90-95% of literacy rate. If that boom happens and learning becomes, being very accessible, are we ready for that to happen? Have we built enough teacher capacity in the system to be able to take that load? So that's something we should all start thinking about. The other thing is, are we prepared for technology replacing poor teaching? So we, teacher and student obviously have a very holy relationship, right? Nor yesterday, nor today, nor in the future, technology can ever replace a teacher. But replacing poor teaching, so to speak, right? If that is something technology probably can do in terms of content delivery, in terms of artificial intelligence pointing out student to the right direction if he's failing in a particular area, making sure that, you know, with enough AI, he's able to actually pay good amount of attention to that subject. So those are the some of the things that technology can help, not just the student, but also the teacher to personalize, personalize their teaching as well. Some of the interesting comments we are thinking, seeing around is like what demonetization did to payments, right? Like a couple of years ago, that's what was a boom of Paytm, Razorpay, and a lot of other payment gateways. COVID-19, will that do to education? And this is something that has been, you know, everywhere on social media as well, that this is unfortunately, you know, finally COVID-19 was able to wake up or shake up the K-12 market. So more of a traditional systems, right, so to speak, are they built for an average learner? And to extend that theme, are they built for an average teacher also? And if we need to give our teachers, our kind of wonder teachers who are really equipped and capable of handling those students who are really bright, and also handling the students who are falling apart, right, or falling behind in the class, and they have the capacity themselves to handle all kinds of students, are the systems also built around them for them to be able to do that, right? To be able to personalize their teaching, to be able to monitor every student and give them that particular attention span. So that is another thought there. AI will help in self-directed study, right? Unlocking technology to deliver education. Another core subject which comes up in the industries, you know, what is the role of AI, right? There's an evolved teacher, there's already an evolved student. If you see about this Generation Z, I think they call it, millennials, the children of the millennials, right? That's called Generation Z. They are born with a phone in their hand, right? You can't separate them from digital devices. I mean, is AI going to help unlock the delivery of education and how to make it a self-directed study where you give a student a path, learning path, and then facilitate to be, you know, for him to be on it and be successful? Again, tying it back to the teacher playing a role of a facilitator and not being actively delivering content, but being there as part of a mentor, facilitating all the learning that's happening, right? Facilitating active learning. And also inculcating an entrepreneurial mindset, right? There are a lot of life skills that are left behind. There are a lot of other kind of ancillary things which parents are now looking up to teachers to teach the kids, including an entrepreneurial mindset. How do we navigate this? So there was a very interesting fact that jobs, right? 80% of the jobs that will be available in 2030 and beyond, we don't even know what kind of jobs they will be. So you can imagine what kind of skills we need to learn. We don't even know what kind of jobs they'll be. They'll be very different from the jobs available today. And 80% of those, we have no clue what they will be. So you can imagine where we are going with all this. We have to be very agile in learning new skills. And the same thing has to be passed on the students and making sure they have that kind of a mindset of lifelong learning. So over to you, Daksh. I think we'll come back to this after we hear thoughts from everybody else.
Thank you so much, Charu, for actually detailing out the questions that we are looking at for the answers from all these educators who are here. So let's try and understand from you that what do you think would change in the future teacher, or how would the future of your teacher change? Just trainings or the kind of teaching that we had till now will have to drastically or dramatically change? या क्या आप वो छोटा बड़ा चेंज आप चाहेंगे कि जो टीचर में तुरंत हो जाए, जिससे आपके जो अभी बच्चे ऑनलाइन हैं उनका भी एंगेजमेंट लेवल बेटर हो जाए, और जब आपका स्कूल रीओपन हो तब उन बच्चों को एक बहुत मेजर इमोशनल मिसिंग हो रही होगी, जो उन्हें वापस चाहिए, वो इमोशनल कनेक्ट वापस चाहिए होगा स्कूल के साथ, वो वापस अपने दोस्तों से मिलना चाहेंगे, बहुत सारी सोशलाइजिंग होना चाहेगी, बट हमें उस समय भी सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग को कॉशन करना है, टीचर्स के एक्सप्रेशन जेस्चर्स काम नहीं कर पाएंगे क्योंकि मास्क हर समय पहनना है. So there are a lot of typical challenges. So let's see what's your perspective on how would these two things change. So let's now first hear it from Basanta sir. Basanta sir, over to you for the next 2 minutes. You can unmute your audio.
Thank you, Mr. Dux. I would like to compliment Mr. Saru. Basically, the post COVID-19 scenario will be very different. Basically, what I'd like to know, what I'd like to set up one core issue, especially how we have to develop the teaching line that we have to train the teachers. Number one, teachers have to know the technology, how we have to integrate the technology into the classroom, apart from the ongoing one. So here, my concept is blended learning and blended teaching, the offline teaching as well as online teaching. So that one, Mr. Sirui has already seen. So what we have to make it, number one, teacher has to keep on learning, number one. Teacher has to be creative. Teacher has to be, you know, that they are communication, the fundamental things, the three R as well as C four. So everybody has to, everybody knows these three R and C four. So we must not leave behind this one. Along with that one, we have to integrate all the technology, right? If we continue this, during the COVID-19 crisis, what our teachers have to learn, they have to carry on, they have to just go ahead, right? Say for example, they have to know how to go to digital, and they have to go to the world just by clicking, and how they have to collaborate. Say for example, we are collaborating with each other, and with the help of this technology, technology keeps changing, and technology keeps changing our life also. So accordingly, our teachers have to change the way how they have to teach. The methodology we have to develop is now many companies and many industries are coming up to help us also. We have to align with them. So back to the next.
Thank you so much, Basanta sir. Actually, integrating technology very seamlessly into the class is a very big challenge right now. So we are all trying to find out ways of how to do it. Would it just be easy to give trainings, or it will be more about simulations or what? Let's see how we find out those solutions. Let's now hear it from Alpa Prabhu, ma'am, who's the principal of Sagar Public School, Gandhinagar, Bhopal. Ma'am, over to you for the next 2 minutes. You can unmute your audio.
Thank you so much, dear all. A very happy evening. Today is the tomorrow we worried about yesterday. So a future teacher actually will design the teacher's future. Now there is a paradigm where virtual reality will have to balance any question, intellectual, emotional, adaptability, spiritual, and also to integrate artificial intelligence in her. And so a future teacher is expected to have a healthy body and an open technology as well as learning. Now here will be the seesaw teachers. A teacher has lifelong learner. We, the millennial teachers, as told by Charu, will require digital literacy and to stay one step ahead of the born digital literates of the Generation Z. Now, with an uncontrolled exposure to virtual world and less human connect, the future teacher will have to be an excellent counselor, with children today losing the real connect and developing the virtual connect. See, today children are in isolation and it is not by choice. So here the role of values are pivotal, and the reinforcement of the value-based teaching, I truly believe, will be the need of the hour. And right now what I feel that monotony is the thing of the past, and the teachers have to develop excellent communication skills with expressions, voice modulation, and along with very strong intellectual content and presentation skills, since the classrooms have become digital. So one should also address the responsibilities of the teachers increasing. They have to address the issues of safety, hygiene, and the most important, what I believe, that they have to make our children sensitized to respect and connect with nature. So no more it is my class, my students, my influence as a teacher in person will work. Now I feel the future teachers are going to be focused more on quality content, the future of the teachers. So the mindset has to change.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Actually, the 2 minutes were over. We'll have to stick to the time today. I'm really sorry we had to cut you through, but we'll again try to come back if it's possible within the call. Thank you so much, Alpa, ma'am. Let's now hear it from Rajeshwari, ma'am, who's the principal of Gwalior Glory High School, Gwalior. Ma'am, over to you for the next 2 minutes. You can unmute your audio.
Yeah, good evening, everyone. I've been listening to Charu, Alpa. Yes, the future teacher has to groom herself to such an extent now that digital learning becomes part of school teaching. Technology enhanced learning, once upon a time we would talk about technology enhanced learning to be 30%, but now it's the roles are reversed. It's more of 70% technology enhanced learning and 30% of teacher intervention, because children are now used to the virtual classrooms. They are used to assignments being posted on the Zoom or MS Teams. They are submitting assignments online. So a teacher has to adapt to this technology even when school reopens. Besides that, of course, as Alpa said, that the spiritual and the moral upbringing of children needs to be taken care of, the safety and security. Those are all very common things that we need to watch out for to educate children as to maintain that distance, because everyone knows that COVID-19 is going to extend up to 2022. So that social distancing and hygiene are very, very important. And a teacher plays a very important role in driving this into the minds of children. And virtual learning, virtual teaching has brought in a great transformation.
Thank you so much, Rajeshwari, ma'am. Let's now listen to Sangram Singh, sir, who's the principal of Gautam International Academy, Dhar, Madhya Pradesh. So Sangram, sir, over to you. You can unmute your audio.
Yeah, thank you so much, Daksh. And the future teacher, I mean, there are now two ways of teaching, online teaching, and when the classroom opens, the school opens. So very shortly, I would like to say that for online teaching, the teachers must be very engaging, because maintaining students' attention online is a really difficult task. They must have to be very much strong at technology management and obviously very good at data analysis, and they have to be expert at cyber safety when they are online teaching. Cyber safety is a very important thing. When the schools reopen offline teaching, the students shall be coming after a panic time. They will be in a panic mode. So the teachers must have to be a kind of behavioral analysts. They must understand the change in the behavior of their students, and then they should work as mentors and counselors for the students. They must develop very much strong social skills. Their social skills must be very strong to handle the children. And obviously, they must be divergent thinkers and create a kind of system in which they can enhance learning outside the school walls as well. That is all from my side. Thank you. Thank you, Daksh.
Arun Sharma, sir, who's the principal of DAB Police Public School, Fatehabad. So, Arun Sharma, sir, over to you.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you, Dax. Thank you, Charuman, for your valuable thoughts. In my view, a future teacher to be a great learner, as we know how our education system is changing. I feel future teacher must have the adaptive learning nature so that they can easily change the strategies.
Can you speak loudly? Your voice is not audible clearly.
Okay. Once again, future teacher, I feel, must be a great learner, as we know how our education system is changing. I feel future teacher must have the adaptive learning nature so that they can easily change the strategies according to the situation when students will come back to our schools. The skill which I feel all teacher must have is a spiritual skill in terms of meditation, which will help the students to empower and to come out with the situation of excessive use of technology, and which will help in their mental growth also. That I feel we should, as other principals, fellow principals have already said somewhere, counselor, where I feel they must have this skill, spiritual skill. And my future teacher must be so impactful on children that his or her thoughts, knowledge, beliefs must impart to the plant in the minds of the students. So at last I will say the meditation thing will help us, help the students in come out from this technology, excessive technology thing, and teachers must be adaptive learners. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. And spirituality and values and but good social skills will now play a very major role in teaching, because actually re-inducting a student in the class would need a lot of effort. So let's now hear it from Kanu Charan Panda, sir, who's the principal of Chinmaya Vidyalaya, Rayagada, Odisha. So over to KC Panda, sir.
Sir, good evening, sir.
Good evening.
And the future teacher is the more skilled person, and he must be the more responsible after the reopening the school. And today's the teachers are already skilled by phones, laptops, tablets, and they are taking the classes in online. And after the physical classrooms, they when they'll take, and the students are very anxious to meet with their friends. At the time, for this coronavirus, we all are alert, and so that the teacher must be the more responsible during that period, and he will be the more guide, more counselor, and evaluator during that period. And the digital tools are the complement, but not substitutions. So we need the physical classroom essential. So teachers must be the good to handle the students properly in the after reopening the school. Thank you, sir.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, sir. Let's now hear it from Neeti ma'am, Neeti Tripathi ma'am, who's the vice principal of Cider International School, Bangladesh. Ma'am, over to you. Let's add a perspective to the talk.
Hello. Good evening, everyone. This is Neeti, and I'm in Bangladesh as of now. Well, I'm going to say that future teachers, there are a lot of skills required for them, but I'm going to today talk about three things. That's LCD. LCD is very, very important in my eyes. What is L? L is the life skills. The teacher should be able to teach life skills to the students in future. And they can only do it if they are, you know, having those skills. Like they will be emotionally balanced, they will be risk takers, they'll be honest. These kind of life skills will be very, very important in future. Now I'm going to say CC is the child psychology. In future, the teachers, there's no separate concept of having a counselor in the school or a teacher. The teacher has to be the counseling part, doing the counseling part also. They also have to be the counselor. They should be able to understand the child psychology. Especially after this pandemic, there are a lot of changes in children's thoughts. They have come with a lot of, lot of knowledge, and I would say all sort of knowledge. So how the teacher is going to deal with that? So they must be able to deal with child psychology. And the third part, LCD, the D is digitally or technically sound. They have to be very, very digitally sound so that they can take care of all those flip classroom, blended learning, and all these kind of things. So I would say that in future, the teacher have to be basically focusing on the life skills development of the students. They need to be understanding the child psychology. They need to understand what children are thinking, what's going in their mind, and they have to be digitally sound. They should be able to take care of blended learning, flipped classrooms, online teaching as per the need. We don't know what's going to be happening in future. So that's from my side. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Let's now hear it from Abbas sir from Ahmedabad, Gujarat. He's the principal of Jamale School, Ahmedabad. Abbas sir, over to you.
Thank you, sir. Am I audible to all?
Yeah.
Okay, sir. And thanks to you, the whole team of Bulb World, for creating this platform for all of us. So the future teacher, what I want to suggest for present and for the past might be that the teacher should have passion in teaching. So that passion in teaching will help to arise him or her from all above the arise above all the circumstances, problems, and the hurdles we are facing. The passion will create a platform for every teacher to adopt what is going around the surrounding. So if we talk for the present day, nowadays we are suffering the COVID-19. So what will happen that if we talk about the teaching, the best teaching is what comes with the transformation of the students into the good society, educated society, civilized society. So if that the transformation of the student is done with the help of the technology, then we are doing it best, because the job of the teacher is to transform the students. And the other point what I want to share is that the future of the 21st century teacher should focus not only on the marks or the examination, but also on the skills and the talents and the abilities of the students, which I think with the help of the technology, digital curriculum, digital content, and the curriculum having skills and talent with the help of the virtual classroom, I think the teacher can do the best. So that's all from my side. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Abbas sir. And as it is with every industry, every passion, as every profession, that your passion actually plays the key role. Passion only, you know, pushes you through to learn new things and stay updated. Let's now hear it from Yogeshwar Dubey sir, who's the Vice Principal, Gurugram Public School, Gurgaon, Haryana. So Yogeshwar sir, over to you for the next 2 minutes. You can unmute your audio.
जैसे कि आपने मैं हिंदी में ही बात करूंगा बिना किसी लाग लपेट के. आज COVID-19 यानी कि नोवेल कोरोना वायरस के कारण जो शिक्षा के क्षेत्र में विद्यालयों में और विद्यालय परिवेश में और शिक्षकों के बीच में तमाम बातें देखने को मिली, उनमें सबसे पहले मेरा आग्रह यही है कि हम लोग पुराने गुरुकुल के वातावरण को भूल गए थे, इसलिए प्रकृति ने उस वातावरण को दोबारा हमारे सामने लाकर खड़ा कर दिया. हाँ, अब इतना अवश्य हुआ कि हमने डिजिटल प्लेटफॉर्म्स के माध्यम से एजुकेशन देने का कार्य तो किया, लेकिन जो प्रॉपर डिस्टेंस गुरुकुलों में हमारी पुरानी शिक्षा पद्धति में दी गई थी वो हम मेंटेन नहीं कर सके आज के समय में, इसलिए हमें ये दिन देखना पड़ा. तो जब विद्यालय रीओपन होगा उसके लिए सबसे पहले हमें लोगों को प्रॉपर उसी प्रकार से प्रॉपर डिस्टेंस, प्रॉपर गाइडेंस यानी कि अनुकूल वातावरण, बीमारी से बचने का, संक्रामकता से बचने का ये क्रिएट करना पड़ेगा. रही बात इसकी, हम लोगों को सबसे पहले अपने विद्यार्थियों में सबसे पहले जो मूल काम है वो है उनमें मानवीय मूल्य डालना, उसमें ह्यूमन वैल्यू को डालना, क्योंकि जब तक हम ये नहीं डालेंगे तब तक हम प्रॉपर डिस्टेंस, व्यक्ति ये सोचेगा हम तो सही हैं कोई बात नहीं, इसको लग जाए या ये हो जाए, इससे कोई लेना देना नहीं, क्योंकि एक अगर डिसीज से संक्रामक बीमारी से आएगा तो निश्चित रूप से बहुत बड़े वातावरण को लेकर जाएगा. सबसे पहले हमें प्रॉपर डिस्टेंस मेंटेन करनी है, अपने आप को सिद्ध करके दिखाना है कि हमें ही प्रॉपर डिस्टेंस क्लासरूम में विद्यालय में बनानी रहा। फ्यूचर के टीचर्स का सवाल, हम लोगों ने टेक्नोलॉजी जो नवीनतम विधियां हैं उनका प्रयोग किया, लेकिन आज के समय में मैं बता सकता हूं लगभग 30% विद्यार्थियों ने 30% विद्यार्थियों ने इस नवीनतम विधाओं का प्रयोग होते हुए भी उनका प्रयोग नहीं किया, बस अपने को ऑनलाइन दिखाया, वीडियो में एक जगह सेट किया और अपने चलते बने। केवल इतने मात्र से ही शिक्षा का स्तर बढ़ जाए ये संभव नहीं है, हम सब लोगों को मिलकर।
थैंक यू सो मच योगेश्वर सर, द टाइम वाज ओवर। लेकिन हाँ, एक बात आपने जो कही वो बहुत अच्छी थी कि बच्चों ने इस समय का कुछ बच्चों ने, मैं कह सकता हूँ शायद, इसका बहुत अच्छे से इस्तेमाल नहीं किया। उन्होंने टीचर्स को और सिस्टम को हैक करने की काफी कोशिश करी और बच्चों ने किया भी होगा, बट मुझे लगता है कि अब ये सब डिजिटल अरीना में ये सारी चीजें रहनी है तो हमें ये समझना होगा कि टीचिंग कंटेंट जो है, ये जो हम बच्चे को पढ़ा रहे हैं उसके अंदर एक बहुत बड़ा एंटरटेनमेंट या एंगेजिंग फैक्टर बिल्ड करना पड़ेगा जो कि टीचर की स्किल से आएगा। इसीलिए हमें अब ये समझना होगा कि टीचर अब केवल एक टीचर नहीं हो सकता, उस टीचर को टिपिकली एक मीडिया वाले की सारी स्किल्स सीखनी पड़ेंगी कि उसकी कंटेंट डिलीवरी, उसकी बात करने का तरीका, कंटेंट सॉर्ट करने का तरीका। सो अ टीचर वुड नीड अ डिफरेंट पर्सपेक्टिव ऑन ऑल दिस। सो थैंक यू सो मच सर फॉर एडिंग दैट। हियर इट फ्रॉम पूनम मैम नाउ। पूनम मैम, ओवर टू यू फॉर द नेक्स्ट 2 मिनट्स। यू कैन अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ।
थैंक यू दक्ष एंड गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। ऑल्दो एवरीवन हैज ऑलरेडी कवर्ड मोस्ट ऑफ द पॉइंट्स, so there is nothing left for me, but still I feel that, you know, future teachers, they need to be more connected, more connecting with students, with parents, with content, and of course with technology. Then only they'll be able to keep the children engaged, whatever they want to teach them. And apart from that, you know, everyone is thinking that the future of the teachers would be in danger, but what I believe and what I have observed, the future of the teachers is completely safe now, because this has been observed by the parents. Because, you know, every parent is waiting ki kab school khulenge, kab ye bachche jayenge ki hum apne kamon ko aur tarike se kar sake. So the importance of the teachers have been increased now, because children, they are also looking forward to the person who used to listen the child all sort of talk, all sort of things generally which children are not getting at home. Or of course, teachers need to be more social. They need to be understand the child's psychology, so that according to their age, they can understand the children and they can sort out their problems if they have any issue. So future teacher need to be more connected. They need to be more able to deliver the things, everything they need to do. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Poonam ma'am. ये बात एकदम सही है, it's absolutely proven now that teacher's role has now become more and more critical. But ये है कि teacher अब वैसा teacher शायद नहीं चाहिए जैसा पहले चाहिए था, अब थोड़ा सा अलग तरीके का teacher चाहिए जो बहुत ज्यादा emotional connect बच्चे को दे सके, उसकी emotional intelligence को build कर सके और उसे एक conducive environment build करके दे सके classroom के अंदर। क्योंकि content तो बहुत सारे तरीकों से बच्चों को मिल जाएगा, but ये support और ये understanding बच्चों को और तरीकों से नहीं मिलेगी। So let's now hear it from Arif sir, Arif Ali sir, the principal Indian Excellence School from Madhya Pradesh. Sir, over to you for the next 2 minutes.
So first of all, thank you for giving me such chance to speak on the topic. Now the teachers who are going to face this challenge after COVID-19, they will be facing like the lady who is going to become first time mother. They have to face a lot of problems, not only with the children, along with the parents also and the management side also. This is the first thing. As in the earlier meeting, I had discussed, each and every classroom has to be digitalized. But I don't know how far our this system, school, Indian schools or other schools, they have been managed to put up all these things. Very few schools, they are keeping all these things to be digitalized. Otherwise, this problem, what we are facing today, the learning technology have not been faced. Now, this is the future teacher, worried whether the teachers will be there for future or not, because the technology is replacing them. That is not going to be replaced. Teachers, they are not going to be replaced by the robots or other things. But the thing is that whether the teachers will get their own particular part COVID is, that is a 3 months time. If I don't know whether the school will open or not after 3 months also. This is the thing. The first thing is that the teacher has to counsel not only with the children, along with the student also, the parents also, as well as they have to be counseled by the management also. The teachers have to be counseled by the management, and so the teacher will be counseling the parent and the student. The teacher has to face, they have to be more focused on practical approach, not only the bookish knowledge, practical approach. As far as I feel that nowadays the Mahabharata and Ramayana, all these things are going on. If you are going to ask any of the child to read it, no one will read that book. But 99% of the students, they will be seeing, watching that on the TV. So this visual system has to be followed in each and every concept, each and every concept of the teaching. So thank you, that's this I want to say only. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. And actually taking education to, you know, a completely visual medium rather than a written textbook medium or a blackboard medium would now be the need of the hour. And I think Charu and her associates are doing something interesting in that direction only. So let's hear it from Charu, that how does she think, or her organization think, that education will become more visual, more interesting and more engaging. So over to you, Charu, for the next 2 minutes. And over the next 2 or 3 minutes, over to you.
Thank you so much, Daksh. I think my notebook is already full. I've got some amazing thoughts from all these, illustrious people who've been doing really, working very hard on the ground. I think I'm always wowed by the thoughts that are presented to me from, from the school management side, teachers, and the mindset of the academician. At a core, they're so passionate. I mean, you can see all the passion bubbling here through this, the thoughts. And I can sense a little bit of that, turbulence also, where in each one of them, where I feel that there is uncertainty, right? This is something that we've never faced in our lifetime before. So I think there is a little amount of uncertainty. As everybody says, unprecedented time. It wasn't there in my vocabulary before this happened, unprecedented. But now I hear it like a couple of times every day, because this is really unprecedented. This is what we mean by it. So, and a couple of amazing thoughts, just to recap, that the 30 and the 70% that Rajeshwari ma'am said, that how technology and teacher assisted is going to now immediately reverse. 30% is going to be the teacher assisted learning, whereas technology enhanced learning will be 70%. Very, very interesting thought. And, I think RF sir mentioned that practical learning is going to be here, and that's how, the way to go. So I think some of those thoughts are very, very nice. And I think Itima mentioned about the LCD, which is also something that I've noted down, which is a very, very engaging thought about life skills, child psychology, and digitally sound environment. So what we here at Practically do, just to, introduce ourselves, we are, supporting teachers in their, how do we support in this whole paradigm of, taking learning, online, and how do we facilitate that journey is something we, hold on, I'm just going to play a video here. And how do we kind of, fit into all this? How, where Practically can actually help teachers, management, and people from the academic industry to bring practical approach to learning, bring much more experiential learning, so to speak. So I'm quickly going to play a video. Sharing my screen here.
Curiosity is our most basic instinct. It fuels our desire to learn, to open pages that we otherwise wouldn't. But sometimes those pages aren't enough. So we ask, what if? What if our books come alive in front of us and let us touch things we never knew we could? What if we could learn with each other and get better together? What if our lessons were movies? Movies that we could be a part of. Presenting the world's most advanced learning application. Fuel your curiosity with Practically.
So this is just a teaser, you know, video which we have created to kind of just the idea around how we can make learning, you know, you can touch and feel learning. As I said in the beginning of the session, there is no pass and fail in learning, right? How do we inculcate this whole idea that how learning can be made more practical and how you can make it effortless? It should, you know, there's a distinction between learn and study. And we keep saying, bachche do ghante padh lo, you know, keep study for 2 hours, this is your study time. But learning is all the time happening. Learning is everywhere and learning is ubiquitous, right? So that's what are the fundamental principles about, you know, who we are. And so we are an, you know, young insurgent brand and an evangelist for limitless learning. We are a very small, you know, we're not small now, we've grown. We have about 300 people working within the company, but we still believe we are a young insurgent brand. An evangelist for limitless learning. We believe there's an explorer in each of us, but conventional education stifles our zeal to learn. So conventional education is now actually under transformation and it kind of stifles the zeal to learn is what we feel. So that's where the experiences, the experiential, that's where the innovator's role within a teacher comes out. How do we make this much more fun? And our vision is to reshape the way the world learns, right? So it's a challenging task and we can't do this alone, of course. We need partners, we need supporters like you, we need people in the education industry to be behind us in achieving that vision. And this is, you know, where our passion lies, to help education transform. We can, you know, we do this by reimagining the way learning comes alive, right? Some of the products we work on where we bring textbooks alive. We democratize limitless learning. We empower teachers to leapfrog. So, you know, teachers themselves can upskill. A ninth grader teacher, you know, math teacher may want to teach 10th grade math next year. So how do they upskill and learn? We lead an ecosystem of world-class partners. So this is what, you know, what we are. We want to build a global brand, obviously, that compels advocacy. And this is all learning from... we have a Practically School solution that, you know, if you're interested, you know, we can my team can introduce that to you. But essentially some of the questions that why this slide was not part of my original deck, but why I put it here is some of the issues that I heard, right, where students are actually distracting the class and a lot of communication tools where there is online discipline is become a problem, right? So a lot of those things is something from which lens we look at, where the solution has a school from home.
Charun Aurya is talking.
Yeah. And assessments and access to all digital materials, right? So all this is something we bring in. It supports flipped and blending learning models. I think some of you mentioned about those learning models being part of that, in the future. So that is it, Daksh, from my side. We are Practically. You please drop me a note if you need to, you know, we can connect later or any thoughts, or I always love connecting with educators. So.
Thank you so much, Charu. So this talk was basically targeted at finding out that whether teachers would need training or we would need new teachers or we would need a completely new HR policy and a look towards a school. I think some of these observations and some of the ideas that you shared would actually make more sense if we create a combined summary of all your thoughts. And we'll be sharing a small, paper with you. Something, if you want something more to be added, just to share one or two news with you. First, Blub is going to do a specific school finance webinar where we'll be having around 5 or 6 educational investors and debt providers come in from all across the world. We are going to help you in actually managing the school's debt and investment. If you're looking for investment in the school or if you're looking at debt and how to manage the school's fees and other things at this time when you're actually not allowed to charge fees and a lot of schools are financially struggling. So we are going to do a very dedicated specific talk just on school finances. So we'll be sending you an invitation for that as well. एंड आप में से बहुत सारे लोगों ने अभी तक हमारे साथ जो आइडिया शेयर करे थे वो हम लोगों के पिछले महीने की मैगजीन में ऑलरेडी छप गए हैं, उसमें से 96 आइडियाज सेलेक्ट हुए थे एंड वो 96 आइडियाज अभी प्रिंट हो गए हैं, तो भी आप सब तक वो मैगजीन की कॉपीज आएंगी, सो यू कैन एक्चुअली सी देम देयर. एंड अगर आपका कोई आइडिया मिस हो गया हो एंड इफ यू वांट टू शेयर समथिंग यू कैन स्टिल शेयर विद अस बिकॉज वी आर राइट नाउ क्रिएटिंग द सेकंड व्हाइट पेपर व्हिच इज ऑन द पोस्ट लॉकडाउन स्कूल, सो इफ यू हैव सम आइडियाज ऑन दैट यू कैन ऑल्सो शेयर दोस. अगर आपने कोई ऑब्जर्वेशन पेपर्स लिखे हो प्लीज शेयर, वील बी अगेन पब्लिशिंग सम ऑफ द बेस्ट ऑब्जर्वेशन पेपर्स दैट कम टू अस. And a very good news for all of you, कि आपने जो ideas हमें दिए थे उन ideas का white paper मतलब थोड़े ही दिनों में एक special webinar करके जिसमें आप सबको हम लोग बुलाएंगे उसमें we are inviting the honorable Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla ji and आपके वो ideas हम उन्हें आपके नाम के साथ देंगे ताकि those ideas can be pushed to the Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India, ताकि शायद आपके कोई ideas कहीं ना कहीं policy में कोई change ला सकें. So I hope all of you have shared a lot of great ideas with us and you'll keep sharing with us. So I hope you enjoyed the last 20-30 minutes. If you did and if you want to again join future sessions, you can open your audio, say a big yes. And this is the time to conclude the talk. So just open the audio, say a yes. And thank you so much people for being here. Yes. On the Blub World Web Talks 43rd edition. Yes. Ye aaj Blub World Web Talks ka 43rd episode hai. So thank you people. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.